5-star ratings only come with doing a quality job. Hey, I'm John Gardner. Let's talk a little bit about duckbill seals going into a GM rack. Now, a duckbill seal is called that because it looks just like that. This is the duckbill. Now, here's the cool part. Check this out. When you're installing these duckbill seals, you want to actually lube them up in the OE specified fluid, the power steering fluid. Then you want to come down and you want to pop them in the rack. The tendency sometimes is to put them on the line. Don't do that. Put them down in the rack, make sure they're seated, and they're good to go. Now, after you do that, what you want to do is you want to take your lines and go ahead and put your lines together. Make sure they're lined up and they're right. And then when you do that, you want to come down, and you want to come down kind of gently down in here, and you want to go straight down as you push down. You may hear a little bit of pop when it goes through the perforated duck seal, and then it's sealed. Now, just as important is the torque specification. Make sure you use the right torque specifications, because if you don't, you'll contour the lines, you could twist them up, and you'll have a leak every time. So use your torque specifications, lubricate them, put the duckbill side down, and you're guaranteed not to have any leaks.